Hi, I'm Mark.
And I'm John.
We're both engineers on the Google Cloud SDK team. Today we're going to be giving a brief walkthrough of the Cloud SDK and specifically the new gCloud command line tool.
Here at Google, we've been working hard to create a great cloud platform, and we know that for a lot of you, this means a great command line experience too.
The Google Cloud SDK gives you everything you need to work with the Google Cloud platform in a single, convenient package. The new gCloud tool is a complete rewrite of the existing cloud command line interfaces you might be aware of, with a specific focus on product integration, ease of use, and of course, command line power. The best way to show off what gCloud can do is just to show you.
Let's start with a situation we've all been in, being a new developer on a project team. You're an experienced developer and you know how to code, but you don't know the tools your team uses, the workflows they follow, or how to get started. Fortunately for us, this app is built on the Google Cloud platform. Your new tech lead tells you to go grab the Google Cloud SDK, that your project name is gCloud Demo IO 2014, and that there's a bug in production needs to be fixed right away.
We don't really know where to start, so we search for the Google Cloud SDK, and we land at Google's developer site, where we see some installation instructions.
The setup looks pretty easy. Run one command to install, and then run gCloud auth login on the command line.
We've created this one-liner that can take care of the whole installation process. If you're on a system with bash, paste it into a terminal, and follow the instructions. Follow the prompts to choose some installation options, and it will then download and install the latest version of the SDK. Okay, so we have the Cloud SDK now. The website said it installed the gCloud tool. That seems like a good place to start.
If we run gCloud with -h, it's going to tell us about all the things we can do with gCloud. The developer's site instructions mentioned running gCloud auth login, so let's do that first. When you run that command, it'll take you to an authentication page where you authenticate with your Google account, and then you can give gCloud permission to work on your behalf.
Okay, now we're logged in, but we don't really know what to do next. Let's see if there are any other gCloud commands that look promising. Ah, there's an init command, and sounds like that'll set up a local workspace for us. Looks like it needs a project. Ah, but we have that information.
gCloud init is a command that can set up a local development environment for you and bring in a repository hosted by Google. After the init finishes, there's a directory holding the project's Git repository with all our project files. Now that we have all the code, we need to get work on fixing this bug.
First, let's try to reproduce it with the current code. We need to run this app to see where the problem is hit. I know we run this app on App Engine. I bet there's a command in gCloud for running an App Engine app. Well, it looks like there's an app group. That seems promising. Great, there's a run command. Let's try that. Looks like we need to give it our project directory.
gCloud app run will run your app in a local testing environment on your own computer without receiving any real traffic from the internet. Hey, it looks like it's running. Let's check it out. Sure enough, there's a problem. This stack trace looks pretty obvious though. Let's try and fix it.
So first, let's take a look at our source. Oh. I see what's wrong here. How did this get into production? One of the nice things about the local app server is that it will automatically reload your source if it changes. If we just refresh the page, we can see if our fix is good.
Looks like it's working now. Now it's time to get this fix submitted. Since we're using Git, we can use all the normal Git commands and commit our change and then push it back to our project's repository. You can also configure your project to deploy the app when you push, but for this project and for this demo, we haven't enabled that feature.
Instead, let's use gCloud to redeploy the app, since it's currently broken in production. We need to tell it what version to deploy to. Once the deployment is finished, we can check on the production site to see our fix in action.
That's pretty easy. gCloud had everything we needed to set up a local development environment, make a fix, test our app, and then redeploy back into production. The unified command line and integrated help really helped us figure out the right path to take to get where we needed to go.
All right, let's say now that we work in DevOps and we're responsible for deploying a web application across a farm of machines. How can gCloud help us do this?
First, let's just start with a bunch of empty VMs. We just created them, so they're running Linux, but they have nothing else on them. We want to have our web application running on each one and then set up a load balancer to distribute traffic among all of them so we can increase our overall capacity.
We'll use gCloud to push the files for a custom web server to each machine and to get it running. When we're done, we'll have our server running on a fleet of machines serving traffic through a single IP. We can probably configure each VM manually, but there's a lot of them, and it'd be really handy if we could just script this. Let's drop back into the command line and see how to do this using gCloud.
First, let's find the VMs that we already have running. We can get some basic information about our cluster by running the list command. It shows us the instance name and IP, among other things. For this demo, we only have a couple, but really, if there's any more than one, we probably want to script this. Since the commands can also get long sometimes, we added a shell mode to gCloud. Here we'll just run gcloud compute dash dash shell, and every future gcloud command can emit the first two words.
Next, we'll create a target pool that will refer to each of those VMs. A target pool is simply a grouping of machine between which a load balancer can distribute traffic. For the instances to use, I can just give it the output of the other command that lists all of them. Once the target pool is ready, we can create a forwarding rule. The forwarding rule accepts traffic on one IP and does some basic load balancing between the VMs in the pool we just created. OK, forwarding rule is set up.
Let's see what IP we need to connect to by listing the forwarding rules available. Then we can use curl to connect to the web server. Of course, this isn't going to work because there's no actual software running on that machine yet.
Fortunately, we've got a nice little Go program that will serve HTTP. It's pretty simple. All it does is it tells you the host name of the machine that it's running on. We're using a Mac here, but the program can easily be compiled for Linux.
Now, we need to push our server to all the VMs. We can use SSH and SCP just like normal, but gCloud can even make this a bit easier. The config SSH command will create an alias in your host file for each of the available VMs so that you can easily SSH to all of them without having to remember their IP addresses. Here, we'll use bash in an environment variable that will hold each of our VM names. Then we can use bash to make a for loop that will run SCP and send our server to each of the VMs in our project. Look at them go. Then once that's all set, we can use the same variable and another for loop very similar to iterate over each VM and use SSH to connect and run nohup and sudo that'll run our server in the background.
Of course, the firewall doesn't have anything open by default, so we have to ask for an exception for these machines so that they can actually receive HTTP traffic. We use gCloud to indicate that these machines will be used as HTTP servers and that port 80 should be opened. Since we're making an API call for each instance, we issue these commands in parallel to save some time.
Now, if we make a few curl requests to the load balancer, we can see that it's all working and the traffic's being split between our VMs.
So just like that, we've set up a load balanced pool of machines serving our web app. Of course, this is just one example of the many powerful things that gCloud command line tool can do for you. Check out our developers page to read more about the services we support, or just give gCloud a try on your own.
And we're continually releasing new features, so also be sure to join our Google group to get the latest updates.
Thanks.